respect. Please give dignity to the people. Please give dignity to the people.
So you work for the commissioner, your senior advisor. You were hired 2 weeks ago, and you're instructed to ask us to not have any pictures taken here.
Please respect the people,
because
the
political
rules.
Leadership at DHS does not want the American people to know it.
Please respect the rules,
you keep
sir.
Standing in front of the pictures,
please
so you don't want the pictures taken. The rules are arbitrary,
please,
and they're designed
the
to keep the American
people
in the
dignity
dark.
Dignity and respect. That's all we ask.
Well,
dignity
no, it's
and
not.
Respect.
You're asking, is this
please,
dignity and respect? Look at these people.
Please give dignity
there's a
and
pandemic.
Respect to the people.
Let me ask you. There's a
I
pandemic.
I respectfully ask you, sir.
There is a pandemic. Is this respecting the rights of these kids?
I ask you. Please respect the people.
Are you respecting the rights of these
this
kids?
This is not a zoo, sir. Please don't treat the people.
You're right. And this is a dangerous place.
Please don't treat the people.
And your policies,
like this.
Unfortunately,
you,
are trying to hide them. I understand.
That's
you were instructed. When 18
I
senators came down here,
I ask you to please respect the people, give them dignity and respect.
I respect them, and I want to fix this situation.
We all want
and
to fix this.
The administration
this,
you're working for is
anymore.
Responsible for these conditions.
Please respect the people with dignity and respect.
And
sir.
I ask you to respect the people as well. This
I am respecting
is not
you.
Respect.
I am respecting
is,
the people.
This is not respect.
Spent a day and a half down at the border, and I'll tell you, it is bad. I've been to the border many, many times. It is the worst that I've ever seen it. It is a full-blown crisis. Last month, the month of February, we had over 100,000 illegal aliens crossing over. Roughly 30,000 of them were unaccompanied minors, kids. And just today, the Biden administration has over 16,000 children in custody. We went and toured the Biden cages. You know, for 4 years, we heard Democrats in the media talking about kids in cages under President Trump. Joe Biden has built more cages. The cages are bigger and they're more full. The Donna facility, where that video you just showed was taken, the Donna facility is this giant tent city that they've built. It's massive. It's designed to hold 1,000 people, but under COVID restrictions, its capacity is 250. It right now has over 4,000 people in it. It is at a 1,500% capacity. And that meant you saw in these cages, children, little boys and little girls side by side. They're not 6 feet apart. They're not 3 feet apart. They're not even 6 inches apart. They're lying on the floor. There are no beds. They're lying on the floor side by side. They're covered with aluminum foil emergency blankets. And in that facility, the children there are testing positive for COVID at roughly a 10% rate. So they're locking them in these cages where COVID in a pandemic is a real risk. It is inhumane. It is unconscionable. And it's the direct result of the political decisions that Joe Biden has made.